Well, I woke up this morning, felt around for my shoes, went into work and got the cubicle blues. Yes, I work in a little box for my wage. It makes me feel like a hamster in a cage. And I was thinking about how this all came to be. Didn't really have a melody. So I wrote this talking blues about it. I'm not gonna shout it. I hope you don't doubt it. 'Cause it's a true story. Well, I got out of college several years ago with my suitcase and my guitar in tow. Now, I was looking for work, but jobs were slim pickings for an English major who was crazy about Dickens. I had great expectations. It was a bad situation. More like Bleak House. So I did some odd jobs here and there, while I waited on tables and I cut my hair. I even taught preschool kids for a while, but wiping running noses just wasn't my style. Yes, I was down in the dumps. The kids even gave me some lumps. They also gave me the measles and the mumps. Well, then I took a job as a mental health worker, but sometimes that one could be a real tearjerker. I would talk to the people in the hospital resting, heard a lot of sad stories, made me count my blessings. Well, I met some mighty brave folks, we talk over coffee and smokes. Well, I knew some of them had some issues, 'cause they even laughed at my jokes. So I did that for a while, got another degree, but right around the time I turned 33. Started to think about the future and making more bread, so I thought I'd look into these computers instead. Well, it was all the rage, a different stage. It was the dawn of the electronic age. So I talked to a couple of my computer buddies, and I went to night school and began to study. Things I'd never even heard of before. Technical languages, computer lore. Things like nested if statements, and multiple arrays. And how to write a table to a database. Then I got me a job in a big corporation that made more money than most of creation. Well, I sat at a terminal all day long. I wrote computer programs and forgot all my songs. Now I got a great wife, a daughter, and a cat. And that's the way it's been, that's where it's at. And now I sit there all week. I type and stare like a freak. And now they call me a computer geek. Well, I shouldn't complain, 'cause it pays all the bills. I've made some good friends, it's all right, but still. As we stare at each other over cubicle walls, lots of us are wondering if this is all, there is to life. Corporate deadlines and strife, and business folks with looks that could cut you like a knife. So I picked up my guitar again, I learned a new chord, now I'm much better, I'm not so bored. Well, I'm still in my cubicle, got my technical team. Here's a lesson for you young folks. Hang on to your dreams, whatever they are. You should aim for the stars. And if you meet some people who don't like it, well, all you gotta do is turn around and tell them that they could all go straight to the Dickens.